If you've got a problem and you don't know what to do, find a piece of paper and write down what you're going through. If you need an answer to a question in your life, send a note to Wally. He's always got some good advice. Write a little letter.
Write a little letter.
Jot a little note.
Jot a little note.
Make a little stamp.
Make a little stamp.
And stick it on an envelope.
Put it in the mail.
Put it in the mail. Before the postman comes.
Let us hear from you at Guidepost Junction.
There are lots of stories we would love to share with you. Wally and the Post Kids may even sing a song or two.
In our big computer, we can put the cards you write, and before you know it, out pops the lesson. Good for life.
Write a little letter.
Write a little letter.
Drop a little note.
Drop a little note.
Make a little stamp.
Make a little stamp.
And stick it on an envelope.
Stick it on an envelope.
Put it in the mail.
Put it in the mail.
And before the
Hi, Jody. You say the mail's in? Good. I can't wait to... Snap-a-wowza!
Whoa!
Wow.
I know. Look, it looks like the Mount Everest of mail, doesn't it? All I can say is you sure are one popular turtle.
Oh, thank you, Jody. Although I never really think of myself as popular... I always just think of myself as a green, hard-shelled Chelaedra serpentina.
Chelaedra serpent what?
He means snapping turtle. But Wally never snaps.
No, he just snaps.
Well, I'm sure the kids who write to Wally think of him as more than just a snacking turtle. You know, they think of him as a good and wise and just a wonderful friend.
And speaking of friends, where's Leroy?
Hey, get me out of here!
Do you hear something?
Yeah, sounds like it's coming from someplace close by.
It's Leroy!
Hey, Leroy, what are you doing in there?
Well, he certainly wasn't going to go far with only a 32-cent stamp on him.
I was just reaching in for this letter when I fell in.
Good thing it wasn't the outgoing mail pin.
The letter Leroy found must be pretty important for him to go diving into this mountain of mail for.
Of course it's important. They're all important.
Don't you ever get tired of reading and answering all these letters?
Are you kidding? Children are the most awesome of God's creatures. And helping them get through the tough times, which we all have, you know, is the most very special thing I can think of for a turtle to do.
Oh, we knew that's the kind of turtle you were.
In fact, Jody's right. This one feels so important. I think we should sit down and read it right away. What do you say?
That's what we're here for.
Okay. Let's see. It's from Teresa of Chandler, Arizona. And you know what, Leroy? Since you found it, why don't you be the first to read it?
Great.
Okay. Leroy. Huh? Aloud.
Oh, right. Okay, it says, Dear Wally, I got this problem. My friends cuss around me a lot. I tell them to stop, but they won't listen. It hurts me because they talk about God in a bad way. And then they tease me just because I don't do what they do. Please help me, Teresa.
Wow, that is a problem.
I think it's a very common problem. People are often very thoughtless in the way they speak, and they just don't realize that the words they use can upset people or hurt someone else's feelings.
I know a person who talks like that all the time.
Me too.
You know, I remember a true story that might help to illustrate exactly what we're talking about. It has to do with a boy named Michael who had just moved from a small town to a big city. Now, Michael was not a bad boy, but he was easily influenced by all the other kids around him. Oh, if they talked tough and tried to be cool, he'd talk tough and try to be cool. And when they used bad language, Michael would use bad language too. Oh, and pretty soon, he started using bad language all the time, even around his little sister. It got so that practically all he ever did was swear around her. Now, Michael's sister didn't like this, and finally, one day, she went to her parents and said, "Mommy, Daddy, Michael's hurting my feelings with his garbage can mouth." Well, as you might imagine, Michael's father was very angry, but he didn't spank Michael or scold him harshly. Instead, he did something very wise. He told Michael to go to his room and think of some good things he could do with his mouth instead of talking dirty all the time. So Michael did. He thought long and he thought hard. And this is what Michael came up with.
Laughing and licking lollipops, blowing up bubbles till they pop. There are so many good things you can do with the mouth God's given you.
Slurping up noodles, cause it's fun. Puckering up to someone. Snoring in bed the whole night through with the mouth God's given you.
You can whistle a tune. You can sing a song.
La, la, la.
You can howl at the moon.
Oh.
Or have a sleepy. Hold your breath. You can sneeze.
Just think of all the wonderful things your mouth can do.
You know, when we say God's name, we should say it with respect, because our mouths were made to give God honor and praise. And I can think of lots of ways to do that.
Like telling the truth because it's right, saying your prayers in bed each night, encouraging someone when they're blue with a hug.
And I love you.
You can whistle a tune. You can sing a song.
La, 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 la.
You can howl at the moon.
Oh.
Have sleepy on. You can hold your breath. You can sneeze. Just think of all the wonderful things your mouth can.
What's important is, did we extrapolate any previously unknown insights from it?
He means, did we learn anything?
But I thought I said that.
Well, bad language can become a bad habit. And it's never right to cuss or use God's name in vain.
That's right. Which is something that made God's top 10 list, by the way.
You're talking about the 10 commandments, right? Thou shalt not take the Lord thy God's name in vain.
We have a winner!
Wonderful, Maggie.
And something else I learned is that it's better to be creative and try to think of good things to do and say.
Very insightfully spoken. I have a feeling you'd all make terrific turtles.
Hey, now can anyone think of a moral to this story or what we'll call our guidepost?
What do you mean?
Well, here at Guidepost Junction, we call our lessons guideposts.
Right. So if bad words are dirty, and dirt is kind of like pollution, then when bad words go in our ears, it gives us...
Ears!
ear pollution.
Exactly. And if we wanted to help fight ear pollution, we should...
keep our mouths clean.
I certainly can't argue with that. Oh, boy. Today's youth. I love them.
I'm hungry. I think there's a cookie jar up there.
I don't know if we should, Shira.
It's okay.
Shira, look out!
Whoa, that was close. Hey, are you okay?
You saved her, Wally, just like Superman.
Ta-da-da!
Super Turtle!
Thanks, Wally.
What if Wally hadn't been there? Something terrible might have happened.
Well, that's true. Unfortunately, there aren't always adults around to protect kids from things that go wrong.
But even though sometimes we may feel all alone, like there's no one around to protect us, there is someone who's always watching over us. In fact, look at this. This letter that came over the turtle's backs just now is asking that very same question. Oh, here, Shira, my little cookie climber. Why don't you read it to us? And we'll see if we can't put our heads together and come up with this answer for all of us.
Dear Wally, I am a young girl, 12 to be exact, and I need my parents for everything. I love them, and I ask God, please protect them. But sometimes I wonder if something has happened when they're not home at night or they're late. I wonder, has something gone wrong? Sherilyn from Jacksboro, Texas.
Wow. It seems a lot of kids have these same feelings. And it's very important to talk about them.
I'll say it is.
Hey, in fact, it reminds me of something that actually happened to a family in Florida, where the family's 10-year-old son, Mark, loved to romp in the fields and go on long hikes with his best friend, Bo, his dog.
Come on, Bo. Come on, boy.
Now, Mark knew the dangers that lay in the woods and fields. His father had warned him about them many times.
What is it, Bo?
Rattlesnake.
What'd you see? Oh, it's just a bunch of birds. You've seen that before. Come on, let's go. Ow!
Mark knew that he'd have to do something soon. The swelling would begin, and if he panicked and started to run, well, that would make the poison spread faster, and it would make it even worse. So he made a tourniquet out of his shirt. Oh, but the pain was almost unbearable. You know, he was really afraid.
What are we gonna do, Mom?
Mark. Mark!
They rushed Mark to the hospital as fast as they could.
The poison is very strong. All we can do now is wait and see.
For 24 hours, Mark's family stayed at his side and prayed for him to get well. And then finally, the next morning...
Did you see that? He moved! Doctor! He moved!
Looks like he's gonna be just fine. Don't you remember?
I remember I was bit by a snake, but I don't remember anything until this man came and carried me away.
Oh, sweetheart. You were just dreaming. You probably got home yourself and just thought someone carried you.
No, Mom. There was a man.
I saw you. You were alone.
No, Mom, I wasn't. There was a man. He picked me up. And he talked to me in a real deep voice. And he said I was gonna be real sick, but that everything would be all right. And he carried me home.
What did this man look like? Do you remember?
No, I didn't see his face, but he was strong and gentle. I felt so safe. I knew he wouldn't let anything hurt me. You don't believe me, do you?
Sweetheart, We do believe you.
Sometimes that's the best thing we can do, is hope, pray, and believe.
So you see, even when we don't know it, there is someone who's always watching over us.
Wow, was it God?
Was it an angel?
Yes. Well, I guess that's for each of us to decide on our own.
Do you believe in angels, Wally?
Absolutely. The angel food cake, the California Angels baseball team.
Jim means real angels, Wally.
Well, I believe in angels, and I know Wally does too.
You do?
Absolutely.
And I'll tell you why. Thanks to God, his doctor, and his mysterious angel.
So a good thing to tell Sherilyn and Courtney is that even though we get scared sometimes, we can always gain courage from our faith in God. Because he always knows what we're going through, and he will always be there to watch over us.
Hey, and I know what we can write on the picture as the guidepost for our story.
Oh, what's that, Jody?
Do not worry or fear. God's angels are very near.
Wow, yeah, that's great.
Yeah.
Spencer, stop it.
Stop what? I'm not doing anything.
That's for sure. You're just making her do all of
What's going on here? Is anyone by any chance being industriously lackadaisical?
No.
Yes, Spencer is.
Hey, Spencer, what's the matter? Why don't you feel like working?
Because it's work. That's not fun.
Oh, and life is supposed to be nothing but constant fun, huh? Hey, I think we know better than that.
Yeah, I guess.
And besides, if all we ever did was have fun, then even fun would become boring.
No way. I'd never get bored having fun.
Yeah, and if we were all like you, nothing would ever get done either.
Okay, okay. Hey, I think it's time to read another letter. Let's go. Jody, where's that one I was showing you earlier? You know, the one from the little girl who doesn't like to do her chores.
Gee, maybe it's from Spencer's sister.
Oh, no. Actually, it's from a girl named Erin in Tacoma, Washington. Here, Alexi, why don't you read it?
Dear Wally, sometimes I don't feel like doing my chores. And when it's time to go to bed, I still haven't done them, and I get into trouble. What should I do? Signed, Erin.
Why is everybody looking at me for?
We just thought you might like to try and answer Erin's questions for us.
I think it'd be better for Erin and me if we just let Jody give us an example, by maybe telling us a story.
Well, as a matter of fact, I know the perfect story about a little boy named Peter, and it really happened. Now, Peter lived on a farm in the country, and it was a big responsibility. Peter's grandfather owned the farm, and he depended on Peter to help him out as much as he could. Otherwise, the crops would fail, and there'd be nothing to eat and nothing for his grandfather to sell at the market, and they'd all go broke. Now, Peter's grandfather was a good Christian, but he was also a very stern man. His favorite saying was,
Jesus cried sometimes, but he could be tough when he needed to be.
Jesus cried?
Everybody cries sometimes. Hey, it's all part of being human.
And a turtle.
Anyway, on this particular day, it was very hot, and Peter was feeling particularly lazy. In fact, the last place he wanted to be was out there in that hot field hoeing that hard, stubborn ground. Oh, he wanted to be swimming or playing baseball or pretending he was famous Blackbeard the pirate sailing on the seven seas. When suddenly, Peter saw his grandfather coming across the field. And Peter had hardly done any work. Oh, he was really scared, because he just knew his grandfather was going to use that switch to punish him.
What did he do?
Did he lie?
Did he run away?
Did he get spanked?
Well, let's just finish the story and see. Peter's grandfather looked all around at the field, and he could tell that Peter hadn't been doing his work. Oh, Peter could see the disappointment on his face.
I can't believe it. I just can't believe it. We all depend on one another in this life. And now, with one of the most important harvests of the summer coming up, I come here, and all I see is someone being lazy and selfish.
Peter was sure he was going to get it now, when suddenly...
Let me have that hoe, son. Mr. Ho, I sent you here this morning with my grandson to weed this corn. And what have you done? Nothing! Now you know we depend on this corn to live, but still you refuse to pitch in and do your share. Well, I'm afraid you're just going to have to take your consequences.
And with that, the old man took his switch and started whipping the hoe.
There. I think it's going to do much better now.
Yes, sir. I'm going to get this work done right away. Grandpa, Mr. Ho says he's sorry. And I am too.
He whipped the hoe? Why did he do that?
Spencer, why do you think he did that?
The way I see it, Peter was smart enough to learn his lesson without his grandpa having to hit him over the head with it, if you know what I mean.
But if we do our work and even share with others and help them do theirs, it all gets done a lot faster. And then we have more time to do the things we want to do.
In other words, work with all your might. Do it soon and do it right.
Hey, sounds like a good guidepost to me.
Come on, Alexi. I'll have you finish up.
No, I'll help you.
We'll all help each other. How's that?
Hey, wait for me.
I just love stories with happy endings. Yeah.
Hey, have you guys ever heard the expression, he has the memory of an elephant?
I always thought it was the memory of a turtle.
Well, let's see how well we can remember the lessons we've learned today as we hang our pictures on the guidepost.
This is so cool, Wally. It's like a road sign pointing us in the right direction.
Are these kids smart or what?
Well, the first one was, fight ear pollution. Keep your mouth clean.
Okay, Shira?
Do not worry or fear. God's angels are always near.
Excellent.
And how about you, Leroy?
I can't reach.
Okay. Here we go. There. Oh, good. And what does it say?
Work with all your might. Do it soon and do it right.
Oh, good job, guys. Hey, I think it's time for a pizza.
Pizza? What, did you say pizza? Oh, gosh, I'd love to. But I have to stay here and finish these letters.
Oh, so it's true what they say. A turtle's work is never done.
Hmm, that's funny. I used to hear the same thing about mermaids. But I guess you wouldn't know about that.
Well, only the littlest ones.
You guys!
Well, let's go.
Okay. Dear Holly, thank you for your wonderful letter. And I have to admit, sometimes I don't like doing my chores either. But of course we can't just ignore them, because that doesn't help anybody.
If you've got a problem and you don't know what to do, find a piece of paper and write down what you're going through. If you need an answer to a question in your life, send a note to Wally. He's always got some good. Love to share with you. Wally and the Post Kids may even sing a song or two.